There is a wide variety of surgical instruments and devices used every day in healthcare facilities. But before they are used, instruments must be decontaminated, inspected, and tested to ensure their quality and to verify their integrity. Damaged instruments or instruments that have not been adequately cleaned may cause harm to patients. Therefore, our challenge as central service technicians is to learn how to properly identify, inspect, and test surgical instruments and devices and remove those that fail inspection from service. Begin by getting to know the instruments most commonly used in your facility. Review industry resources, manufacturer instructions for each instrument or instrument set, and become familiar with specific protocols set by your facility. When it comes to surgical instruments and devices, preventive maintenance is the best practice. Being reactive can be costly. Let's discuss some general guidelines for inspecting the instruments you may be required to process. Separate Pakistan-made instruments from German-made instruments. Pakistan instruments are generally shinier, called mirror finish, are manufactured to be disposable or semi-disposable, and can rust quickly. If these instruments are sterilized along with German-made instruments, they can stain the German instruments once the finish on the Pakistan instrument breaks down. However, some good instruments have a mirror finish. Don't dispose of any instruments without verifying that they are indeed disposable. Check all items for cleanliness after manual or mechanical cleaning to make sure they are truly clean and functional before sterilization. Instruments with signs of blood or bioburden should be returned to the decontamination area for cleaning. Instruments with cutting blades should be inspected for nicks, chips, or damage that can hamper the ability to cut or keep blades from working correctly. If the blade is tungsten carbide, inspect for cracks and pitting. Note that when inspecting scissors, the tips are very fragile, so make sure the tips are present and are not bent, damaged, or corroded. If damage is discovered, notify the appropriate person to see if the instrument is under warranty, ensure that the specific instrument is removed from the system, and order a replacement before throwing the damaged instrument away.
Many surgical instruments have cutting edges that will dull with use. The Central Service Department is responsible for ensuring those instruments are in good working order when they reach the surgeon's hand. Because of that, Central Service technicians have to know how to test sharp instruments to ensure that they maintain the cutting edge that's appropriate for their use.
To test the blades of kerosene rongeurs and bone cutters, use an index card. Blades should cut or punch cleanly through the index card. To test the sharpness of curettes, chisels, gouges, and osteotomes, see if they can cleanly shave off pieces of a plastic dowel rod. All scissors go dull at the distal tip first. To test their sharpness, begin by holding them properly in your right hand. Place the rings in the first digits of your thumb and second or third finger. Open and close the scissors. The blade should not be loose or tight. Scissors should slide and close smoothly. Use the proper test material according to the size. For example, use red test material for scissors 4.5 inches and larger, yellow test material for scissors 4 inches or smaller, and orange for latex-free testing material. Scissors must be able to cut clean through at the tips 2 or 3 times without getting snagged. Scissors with dull blades should be sent away for sharpening. Missing teeth on forceps make grasping difficult. Using a magnifier lens, check serrations and teeth to make sure they are all there. In addition, check to ensure tips meet equally and are properly aligned.